What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you the 5 levels of exterior renderings in Lumion. Let's get started. Level 1. For this level, users will just import their 3D models and go straight to the photo mode to render. This will most likely be for those users who don't have much time to spend on their renders and just want some quick mockups of their designs. Even at this level, Lumion is still very useful for creating quick renders. At level 2, you can quickly improve the quality of your scene by upgrading the materials of the imported objects by using the Lumion Materials library. Just go to the Materials tab and click on the surface of an object. Now you can choose any material in the library. Lumion has thousands of materials that you can use, and they are very realistic. Just do this for any material that you like to change. When using Lumion materials, you can double-click it to customize it even more, like changing the color. Also, take advantage of the materials with displacement maps, such as bricks and stones. There are also other useful materials, such as leaves, which is great for creating hedges like these. For the grass material, I can either use the landscape material, which will help blend the imported material seamlessly with the Lumion landscape. If you want something that's higher quality and has more customization, then you can use the 3D grass material, which will let you turn your 2D texture into 3D grass with just a click of a button. There are many presets that you can choose from. If you double-click the material, you can get more options to customize the grass. As you can see, with some quick adjustments to the materials, our scenes already look so much better. As for the render, you can easily improve it by using Lumion styles, which are basically presets built with different effects. So with one click, you can change the look of your render. There are lots of different styles that you can use. You can also make some quick changes, such as the real sky backgrounds and its position. For the scene, I will keep it as a daytime render. Now that we're in level 3, I will show you the importance of composition. So let's adjust the camera angle a bit. First, I will increase the focal length so that the camera angle is not too wide. I can also double-click the slider and type in a specific value like so. Then I can change the height of the camera view here. Next, we need to make sure that the verticals are straight up and down, so I can click this button to align the camera parallel to the ground. Now we can move it to a good position like so, and click here to update the view. There we go! Even just changing the camera angle can make a huge difference. Next, let's use Lumion's asset library to populate our scene with some 3D assets. I'll start by adding some trees to the scene. When adding a 3D object, you can hold L to change the size of the object. And if you hold R, then you can rotate the object before placing it. Lumion also has really useful tools that you can use to place multiple objects at once. Here I'm using the mass placement tool to add some trees. This will help me quickly place multiple types of trees like so. For trees that are closer to the camera, I can use the fine detail nature assets so it looks better. Sometimes you also need to use a landscape tool to transform the environment to make it fit your design better. Here I'm using this tool to transform the terrain to blend it with my 3D model. If you want, you can use these tools to create mountains, lakes, and even oceans. Besides the mass placement tool, there's also the paint placement tool, which is also really useful. And there we go, that looks great. Besides adding vegetation, I will also add some outdoor and indoor furniture for the scene. Lumion has thousands of high quality objects that you can choose. And as you can see, adding 3D objects to your scene is very important. In some cases, you might need to add some surrounding buildings to your scene to help provide some context for the viewer. You can also use 3D entourage and vehicles, which are perfect for urban scenes. Either way, 3D assets are essential for making your scene more lively and realistic. Level 4. For level 4, you need a true understanding of how the Lumion style and effects can change the look of your render. A user who truly understands what each of the effects does will be able to create renders that stands out among the rest. Here I'm gonna go in and make some more adjustments on the existing effects such as hyperlight, skylight, shadows, and reflection. You can see that the change is very subtle. That's because we were using one of Lumion's presets, which already looks really good. But if we compare it to the render without any effects, you can see that there's a huge difference. Remember, when creating multiple views in your project, you can copy and paste effects using these options here. This will let you experiment with different settings without having to recreate them again. Next, I'll create a night scene using one of the sunset real skies. This looks great, but we can add some light to the scene to make it look even better. For the lights, I can change the material to make it emissive like so. Then I can add some spotlights under each light's fixtures, and repeat this process for other lights in the scene. I can also add some outdoor lights fixtures to light up the exterior. With some quick work, I can turn the night render from this to this. Pretty cool, huh? Finally, level 5. At this level, you can use other Lumion effects to create a perfect atmosphere for your scene. For example, I'll use the precipitation effect to create rain. I also changed the real skies effect to a different background that's a better fit for a rainy day. I will also add some reflection planes on the wood deck and the ground for more accurate reflections. That looks good. With the precipitation effect, you can easily switch between rain and snow with a single slider. Similar to the rain effect, you can change additional settings such as particle quantity and size, and even add fog to your scene. If you organize your objects in layers, you can control their visibility with the layers effect. For example, here I can render the scene with the lights off to see which one I like more. There's also the autumn color effect, which lets you change the color of the leaves in your scene. Just select one of the presets, and choose the correct layer where you've placed all your trees. If you have grass and leaves materials, then you might need to go back to the build mode and give them an orange tint so that all the vegetation have the autumn colors like so. For night scenes, you can also use the Aurora Borealis effect. However, you can see that the real sky's background is covering the effect, so I need to turn it off and add the sun effect. Then set the scene to nighttime. There we go, now I can see the aurora effect better. However, it's still blocked by clouds, so I will add the sky and clouds effect and reduce the cloud amount to 0. That's better. And those are the 5 levels of exterior rendering in Lumion. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, and comment below and let me know which level you're at, and if you have any cool tips to share. Anyway, that's all for today guys. Stay inspired guys, and I'll see you next time.